Dear learners, I welcome you for this course 504 for D.El.Ed programs, which is being undertaken by NIOS. I am Dr. Jain Balia from School of Education, Central University of Jammu. And today I'll be sharing with you about very important and vital issue, that is activities for developing creative abilities among primary level students, organization of mathematics club. Now, through this video interaction, I'm sure you will be able to understand the concept of mathematics club in elementary schools, to analyze the purpose of having mathematics club in elementary schools, to understand possible outcomes of having mathematics club in elementary schools, and also I'm sure that you'll be able to be familiar with varied activities that may be organized in mathematics club. At the last, I'm sure that you'll be able to understand the modalities to establish as well as operate a mathematics club in your school. So these are the different objectives of this module. Now, before I talk about how do we establish, how do we operate mathematics club in any elementary school, let me briefly talk about the concept of mathematization of child's thought processes, because that is directly related to the concept and formation of mathematics club. We all understand that every child feels that he has to enjoy his life in the school and outside the school. And as teachers, we all have to try that the children learn to enjoy mathematics. But we all understand that because of some wrong pedagogy, because of some irrelevant methods of teaching in mathematics, a wrong notion has been developed among students and as well as parents also. Then generally we feel that mathematics is a dull, dry and difficult subject. This notion we have to resolve. This notion we have to avoid, and we have to make mathematics as a joyful subject. So that is the first thing we have to make children to learn mathematics in a very joyful atmosphere. Another point which we need to understand, that children should learn important mathematics. What are the different vital issues of mathematics? They should learn through algebra, through arithmetic, through various branches of mathematics. And also, they should be familiar with basic structures of mathematics. What are the different basic structures of mathematics? They should also learn. In next presentations or in the presentation ahead, I'll be sharing all these issues. We also should try that children should pose and solve meaningful problems of their life and day-to-day routine work. That means we have to try to make mathematics as a part of children's life experience. That should be the whole goal of mathematics learning or mathematics teaching in every elementary school. Now, coming to the concept of mathematics club, because mathematics club is basically an opportunity to the students as well as to the teachers to create the climate of mathematization in the school setup. So, first thing we need to understand, dear learners, that mathematics club is an organization of students and teachers who are interested in promoting mathematics in the campus. It's basically a student-initiated as well as teacher-supported academic group dedicated to serve the needs and interests of all students and teachers who are interested and who feel that mathematics is a joyful experience. The important aspect of learning mathematics is mastering practical techniques such as addition, division, measurement, concept of temperature, concept of time, and all. And all that aspects we need to learn, we need to provide the learning opportunities to the students so that they can resolve their life-related issues. This is actually when we talk about what is important maths, all these topics are included in important maths. Another aspect of doing mathematics involves creativity and imagination. We have to try that students should become creative. Their imagination abilities, their imagination power should get strengthened and enhanced. That should be important aspect of any kind of mathematics pedagogy in elementary schools specifically. Coming further, we should understand that as in other subjects, mathematics students should also be encouraged to organize different activities in mathematics club and mathematics association. And under this, we can have different lectures, we can have different programs, we can have different activities, and we can involve the students so that they understand the concepts. All these events, all these functions, all these activities are quite helpful in creating interest in mathematics. When we conduct these activities, when we conduct these programs, it certainly helps in conducting some games based on some concepts of maths, as well as mathematical problems. All these things can also be arranged, these activities can also be organized in under mathematics club or in different aspects of mathematics club. And all these things would likely to help the students in having an idea of practical utility of mathematics in addition to creating their interest in mathematics. Dear learners, I think this is one of the very important issue in whole pedagogy of maths, in whole teaching learning scenario of maths, that the students should understand, students should realize the practical utility of mathematics, and also they should have deep interest for mathematics. This should be our main target, this should be our main goal. Now coming further, we need to understand that what should be the basic or the key purposes of having mathematics club in elementary schools. We generally feel that the students sometimes don't have a positive attitude towards maths, because mathematics should not be taught in a way like you simply provide the lecture to the students or you do some questions in the class. The students should be given the opportunities, they should be given some avenues, they should be given some programs where they can participate, where they can be engaged for different aspects, and ultimately they should have a very positive attitude towards mathematics. Positive attitude means they should love maths, they should have belongingness with maths, they should have basic concepts of maths so that whenever they have any life situation, they are able to apply those concepts, they are able to use those concepts and proceed ahead in their life. So that is one of the basic purposes of having mathematics club in the schools and specifically for elementary schools. Another point which I like to highlight upon is to stimulate children's mathematical curiosity. Dear learners, every child is having a curiosity, and specifically mathematical curiosity. Because behind every act of life, we have mathematics. And every child feels that what is a basic purpose, what is a basic rationale behind any activity. And through the conduct of mathematics club activities, we can stimulate children's mathematical curiosity. The conduct of mathematics club or the organization of different activities under mathematics club would also help in promoting a holistic development of students through games and puzzles. When we talk about holistic development, means it's not only intellectual development, it is also social development, it is also emotional development I'm talking about. It also kind of intellectual sharpening of the students. All these aspects could be covered through different activities in mathematics club. Another point which I think we should understand, we should realize, that mathematics we have to study beyond classroom instruction. Beyond classroom instruction means there's too much of maths beyond our classroom. That should be taken up in mathematics club activities, so that all students should understand that mathematics is an integral part of their life. And they should also be assisted, they should also be stimulated, they should also be developed the deep interest in mathematics, different aspects of mathematics. Further, we say that we should also make the students familiar with the contribution of great mathematicians in their fields. Generally, we feel that the concepts of maths is having a simple contribution, but we should realize the students that behind every concept of mathematics, there's a huge contribution of mathematicians like Acharya Ramanujam, Bhattacharya, Bhaskaracharya, Euclid, and so many, Gauss, all these mathematicians who have given huge concepts of maths. That should also be the part of mathematics club. I'll be sharing ahead now different activities we can take up under mathematics club. Now, mathematics club also helps in stimulating individual interest and initiative in the study of subject matter. Every child has a different level of interest. Every child has a different level of initiative, and that is to be stimulated through mathematics club activities. The mathematics club activities also help in developing heuristic. Heuristic generally means that sense of discovery. Discovering something, that attitude is also developed through different mathematics club activities, and students develop a problem-solving attitude. They understand any problem given to them, the solution lies in their hands. Every solution of any problem lies in their hands, lies in their mind. So they should be develop this heuristic attitude through variety of activities in mathematics club. Now, a very famous, educationist has talked about four basic purposes of mathematics club, in addition to the point which I have already talked about, that is remediation work, challenge and extend, and strengthening group of learners in the class, the group activities in the class, and extended learning opportunities. I would appeal you all to look at the last point, that is extended learning opportunities. That means the learning opportunities which are normally available in the classrooms or any learning situation, those are to be extended, those are to be expanded through the conduct of mathematics club activities. And also, some students have some problems in mathematics. Some students have some problem of slow learning in the mathematics. That can also be taken up through remedial work or remediation work in mathematics club. So that is one of the points which Greven in 2011 talked about four basic purposes, and that is the outcome of research work on mathematics club. Now, what could be the possible outcomes of mathematics club in any elementary schools? Before I actually talk about that, how do we establish and how do we operate a mathematics club in any elementary schools, let me again classify the possible outcomes in two broad categories. One is academic and other is social and emotional, which I'll be taking up further. In academic, the students should have better attitude towards schools. Generally, we feel that students don't like to go to the schools because of wrong pedagogies in the schools, because of the lack of facilities in the schools, mainly the activities which are beyond classrooms. Students always feel that they'll be simply tapped in the classrooms. There'll be no activities beyond the classrooms. Only teachers would come and take up the class. And therefore, they don't have a proper attitude towards the schools. Though they are bound to go to the schools because of societal pressure, because of the parental pressure, but generally, students sometimes have negative attitude towards the school. And that is a wrong symptom of any academic reflection of any school. We should try to resolve this thing by providing some extraordinary activities, some other activities beyond classroom, and that can be taken up through mathematics club. And also, better performance in schools. We have seen generally that schools which have mathematics club, which have well-established mathematics clubs, they have better performance in mathematics as a subject, and students have good achievement scores as well as they have higher grades in mathematics. And also it improves that kind of homework completion. Many of the activities are given through mathematics club and the students do participate. And then better engagement in the learning. Students feel engaged. Students want to get engaged in learning of mathematics if the activities are conducted through mathematics club. And another point which I like to highlight upon is social and emotional benefits. That it improves the self-confidence of the students. Students can also have enhanced self-esteem. Their level of self-esteem can be enhanced through mathematics club activities, and also they have improved social and communication skills. Because communication skills and mainly social skills, I think, cannot be harnessed, cannot be developed in the classrooms only. We need to create some opportunities beyond classroom, and that could be mathematics club activities. When I quote beyond classroom activities, dear learners, you have to understand that I am not talking about the activities to be conducted only off the classroom or beyond the classroom, outside the classroom. I am also quoting the activities which could be conducted within classrooms within the different style and methods. Improved feelings and attitude towards self and the school. This is a very interesting point, that students have improved feeling and attitude towards self and towards the school, as well as towards teachers, towards parents, towards society. And last but not least, because in club activities, students are given responsibilities, so they have the development of initiative and leadership qualities. So this was all like possible outcomes of mathematics club in elementary schools, that intellectual benefits, the educational benefits, the social and emotional benefits. Now come to the main point, that is, what are the different activities that could be organized in mathematics club? You can look at the pictures, that some of the activities which have been listed here, like drawing of charts, pictures, and preparation of models, holding of intra-class, intra-school mathematics resource-making events, where students of other schools, students from different classes can be invited, and students are given some directions, students are given some opportunities where they can organize some resource-making events. And those resources could be used even the normal classroom teaching. You can help and you can take the help of the students. It could be intra-class event, it could be inter-school event, where students, you can see a picture where students are engaged in different activities. They have been given directions, they have been given tasks, and now they are involved in different activities of making some resources for the classroom for different topics. And similarly, we can have some inter-class, inter-school decumulation contest, debates and symposia on some mathematical topics, like concept of zero, concept of discount, concept of compound interest, concept of different algebraic expressions, concept of numbers, concept of division. We can have different activities where we can invite some experts and ask them to interact with the students, and the students can also be given kind of encouragement, where they can have decumulation contest, debates. It's a very debatable point in our country, that should mathematics be taught as a compulsory subject or mathematics should be taught as an elective subject. So all these debates we can organize, all different events we can organize for the students, and good outcomes would be there in these debates and different activities. Another point, we can have some mathematical quiz programs. We can have different puzzles programs. We can have catch problems and riddle competitions, where students can be involved of different classes. Students can be promoted, can be encouraged to participate. on different quiz programs, and the content of these quiz programs, content of these puzzle programs, you see all everything is mentioned in the latest NCF 2005 books, where different activities, different concepts can be taken up as quiz programs, as puzzles programs, as catch programs or riddle competitions. Very important thing, dear learners, is your conduct of remedial classes for the students who are slow learners in mathematics. Already I have shared with you that Greven talked about this thing, that we can hold some remedial classes for the students under mathematics club activities. We can make arrangement of publication of students initiated newsletters or bulletin. That's very good culture we can have there, where the students write some programs, write some poetries on mathematics, write some articles on mathematics, write some puzzles, develop some puzzles, and the school or the class wise we can have newsletters, bulletin made by the students, and we can use the concept of wall magazine there when students post their articles, and that creates, which I started with you all dear learners, that we have to go for the mathematization of the school climate. Then celebration of birth anniversaries of great mathematicians like Aryabhatt, Ramanujam, Bhaskaracharya, Euclid, Gauss, where we can invite some experts. Students should be exposed to different contribution of these mathematicians, and we should celebrate, and then this will also lead to a kind of positive attitude towards mathematics. Students can be told that how did they contribute to the development of maths as well as to the development of society through mathematics. Some more activities we can have under mathematics club, that is arranging extension lectures of renowned mathematicians on some useful topics or issues. We can have some mathematics fair, Ganit Mela, as well as some mathematics exhibition. We can organize different programs. Already I have shared with you in one of the pictures that how could you involve the students, and when you engage them for different activities, resource making activities, you can organize a mathematical exhibition, and then students also feel encouraged that their outputs, their products are being exhibited, and that develops a kind of positive attitude towards the subject and towards the school system. Another point, another activity, set of activities we can have, that is preparing resources for mathematics library and mathematics laboratory. I think, dear learners, you might be knowing now, government is going ahead for this kind of practice, that mathematics laboratory is an essential component of whole school plant, that every school should have a mathematics laboratory, like we have physics, we have chemistry, we have bio, we have computers. And for mathematics laboratory, we need to have resources, we need to have some apparatus, we need to have some kind of tools, and those tools could be developed through mathematics club activities, and their students and teachers can participate. And also for mathematics library, because generally we find that in schools we don't have good books of mathematics library, so that could be thing. And also we can arrange some radio programs, some TV programs concerning to mathematics. We can arrange some programs. Already we have like Swayam Prabha, we have different channels, Gyan Darshan channel and other channels, and some radio programs, we have community radio programs, we have. We can arrange these kind of radio programs for the students through mathematics club activities. Now we are coming to the very important point, dear learners, that how to establish and initiate mathematics club. For that purpose, we should have thorough discussion among students and teachers. We should list out the activities to be organized. We should analyze the resources available in the institution. We should assign duties and responsibilities to the students and teachers. And also we should form an executive body where you can have president, vice president, secretary, mainly from students, and some teachers also. We should prepare, we should establish a core group in the school system which could look after the functioning of mathematics club. But one point I would like to highlight upon, dear learners, that it shouldn't be only executive body. We should ensure that the participation of the students is mass. Every student should be encouraged to participate. Every student should be made a part of mathematics club. And for that purpose, we should have regular meetings. We should have interactive sessions. This is the way you start, you initiate mathematics club in your elementary schools. And I'm sure when you learn this module, you'll also start establishing or initiating the process of establishing a mathematics club in your school. But more important that would be how to operate a mathematics club. For operating mathematics club, you should have regular meetings already shared with you, and there should be proper monitoring of activities organized. Different activities which you organize, you should have proper monitoring. How are these activities being organized? What are the drawbacks? What are the strengths of the programs? So that you can go on improving the functioning of mathematics club. And as I shared with you, that very important point is that involvement of maximum students and teachers, not only teacher of maths, but also science teachers, history teachers, language teachers should also be made part of mathematics club. And we should have futuristic planning of various activities by framing a very comprehensive calendar of the activities of mathematics club. This should be the way you should operate a mathematics club. Now, I have some self-check exercises for you all, dear learners. I am sure that after going through this module, you'll be able to solve these questions, and this will build up a very positive attitude among you all to start a mathematics club in your elementary schools, wherever you are working. What is the rationale behind of having mathematics club in an elementary school? This is the first question which you have to actually develop your mind and write or express wherever you have the opportunity to express. List out some activities you wish to take up in the context of your own school wherever you are working. And prepare a tentative calendar of activities along with the resources required and essential budgetary provisions for the mathematics club. If you need some financial support, you can talk to your headmaster, you can talk to your principal, and you can talk to your students so that you can prepare a complete and comprehensive calendar for activities. So, dear learners, today through this video lesson, through this video interaction, what we have learned today, the concept and the key purposes of mathematics club, the possible outcomes of having mathematics club in elementary schools, varied activities that may be organized in maths club. With one notion, I would appeal you all that make sure that you have a variety of activities and there is a mass participation of the students. You also learned today that modalities to establish and operate a mathematics club in your school. With this, I'm thankful to you all for going through this video lesson, and I'm sure that in future you will have the positive attitude towards the subject, and also you have the clarity of thoughts how to start and initiate the process of establishing a mathematics club in your elementary schools. Namaskar.